Okay, I'm going to give this a second or two to connect, because I always have trouble with Wi-Fi, as we know. See, how big does my butt look today? Yeah, I'm going to give it a second or two to connect, and then I'll go into my little spiel about how off this is and how I'm going to fix it. But you may hear my housemate pulling up. He's getting out of work. It's very... And my dog barked. It's very late on Thursday. It's my first day off in and it's something. Anyway, I'm exhausted, and I'm going to give Wi-Fi a chance to connect, and I'll be right back. I'm scraping off my palette. Oh, shit. I just broke the razor. Oh. Okay, this isn't going to work. It's fairly cleaned off. All right, that was a second or two for that to warm up. All right, so hopefully it's warmed up now and it's connected. Sometimes it takes a few minutes and it's super choppy. Anyway, it's been about a month since I did this, or a few weeks, I can't remember. The last time I did it, I talked about how I started a new job, a 9-to-5 job, which has been a little bit embarrassing for me, but it's just the way it is. It is just the way it is. You know, I'm either working or I'm the proverbial starving artist, which I don't find funny and I don't enjoy. I don't think it's a funny cliche. I find it insulting. But right now, it's just the way things are. And like a lot of artists, including Philip Glass, most of the time, I have to have a 9-to-5 job. You're welcome. And spill kombucha tea. Anyway, so I started my 9-to-5 job. I've been working 6 days, as much as I can, 11, 12 hours a day. I am well beyond exhausted, but I have more of my poor little commission behind me, which needs work. It's gonna get finished up and it needs work. The last time I talked about it, I talked about cutting in and making large brush strokes that had a 3D feel to them, where it was pushing, brush was pushing down the paint and having the Neo McGilp, I'm gonna come in closer so I'm not screaming, the Neo McGilp come up around the brush, really get a textural feel and multi-colors. Like, it's just, the way Neo McGilp works with color is beyond me. So, I mean, it's just, it's charming and entrancing. So I'm gonna be working on that. I also have to restructure some of her face, some of his face, and then go in and cut into this young one's dress. As I said, I've been working 6 days a week, 11, 12 hours a day. There has been zero time to paint. But now that I'm out of the training period in my new job, I'm 1 month out, so I'm out of the training period. I will have 2 days a week of my own to work, and more time at night. So hopefully we're back on track. Anyway, that happened, and then, you know, I got sad a couple months ago. Something happened, got sad, so I apologize for not being more of a connection to artists in the world. Not that I'm that big of a connection, but just being somebody who's out there. I apologize to the people who kind of rely on me to be their studio mate, and here I am now. You know, and something else happened, not to be totally negative, but because my new job is really helping to lift my spirits. I'm interacting more with people. I'm having to sell things, like really give a presentation. And so it's bringing me back to me, where I, you know, I'm more capable of dealing with people and public speaking better than I have been, because I, you know, dealing with a lot of things and getting sad. I can't quite grasp what I want to say, as we've seen. Oh my God, there's bicycle hooks up there. Huh. Anyway, now I have to talk to people every day, all day, And I'm selling like a professional salesman, and it's kind of awesome. It's really helped. But I did want to mention one thing. There is one paint company who I have been a proponent of. I really love. I've been a cheerleader of for 15 years. Just magnificent. I love their products. I especially love their medium. And I used to talk about them a lot. But when I was going through a very hard time, and this is where the metal and the true value system of a company proves themselves to me. A few years ago, someone in the company contacted me. The owner of the company contacted me. They started following me on my social media. They're like, thank you so much. Several people from the company wrote me, thank you so much. I've never asked for anything. I literally have never asked for a single thing. I just promote them because they have a beautiful product. Really beautiful product. Well, this summer when I was struggling, you know, I'd lost my job and I was struggling and I was promoting myself. And this is kind of douchey, like I was not comfortable doing it. I wrote and I asked, I said, do you happen to have a sample pack you could send me? Because I've been out of work for several months. The market is really slow. This is how long I've been promoting you. If you go on my social media sites, you'll see all kinds of posts about you and close-ups of your product, links to your stuff. If you go on my website, I have your product up. And I got a really horrible email back basically saying, you don't mean anything to us as a customer. I mean, not really, but that's how it felt. We do not give away product for free. And I have if you watched since from the beginning, I've talked about this company and some of their products since 2013. And again, I've never asked for anything, but I was down to having no paints. And I thought, you know what, I'm gonna give it a shot because they're up on everything. Pinterest, 3 Facebook pages, Instagram, Twitter, which I don't use so much, but my own website. And it was, thanks, but no thanks. And we don't give people stuff. I've bought their products and given them away in art supply stores. And I don't mean a couple of bottles. I mean, I've bought hundreds of bottles and tubes of stuff and given it away. And it was really rude. And so I wrote back and I apologized. I said, I'm sorry to be coming to you with tin cup out, basically. And I said, but someone from your company sent me a sample pack a few years ago as a thank you gift for promoting you so much. And I didn't even keep it. I gave it away. I gave everything they sent me away to people who couldn't afford the paints or had never tried them and their medium. She said, well, let me have a think. And then like 2 weeks later, I got an email saying, my colleagues and I sat down and had a discussion about you and the letter, and we have decided that we will give you $200 worth of product. This is a one-time offer. So if you never hear me promote it, and I didn't even respond, I was so upset and so fucking insulted, so insulted by this, that I will not be taking pictures of the products that I use or the company, anything from the company any longer. I will not be recommending them again. I know I don't mean anything to them. They made it perfectly clear. I know that my support and my enthusiasm has helped people all over the world find their company. People have driven 7 hours in these places to go out and physically buy their product when they can get it online. And but I'm not recommending them any longer, because although they are a small company and I love their product, none of us apparently matter. So fuck them. And I'm trying to find a replacement, someone who makes a similar product who is less egregious. I mean, I get it, it's a small company, but you're looking at someone who has spent tens of thousands of dollars on paints. I mean, I am not one of the, I'm not one of those artists that's flown around the world. I'm not one of those artists who's being collected by museums yet. I'm not Brian Ratzenberg, whom I happen to love and I watch on YouTube, and he has pictures of their product pouring out of boxes. I get a couple tubes at a time, like everybody else. Sometimes I buy more than a couple of tubes because I have the money. But I will not be talking about them any longer. I will not be recommending them to anyone. In fact, the other day somebody asked me what medium I use, and I said, oh, I've got my own mixture. That's how angry I am right now, how hurt and disgusted I am with the response I got. Yeah, you're welcome. I'm really glad I introduced you to people all over the world. So you can go fuck yourselves, and that's it. Not like I matter again. I'm just little me. You know, the Van Gogh of our time, as I've been called. But yeah, they can go screw. So anyway, no more pictures of their crap. And I'm gonna get to work on this. Yeah, they transformed my way of painting. They also transformed the way I think about them now. I will not be buying their product for people anywhere, whether it's at Michael's or the small art supply store. Anyway, I'm gonna focus on this now and their overly distorted heads and try and fix it. I'm gonna be online for a little bit. I don't know how long. I don't know how good our connection is. Last time it cut out a little bit. But I'm gonna put on a podcast and get to work. I have several other canvases that have been sitting here for about a month waiting for me to get started on them. But this is really important. I've gotta make some progress on it. This one is right now breathing down my neck, and I'm tired of it. Tired of coming home and looking at their misshapen heads that have to be fixed, as well as a few other things. Anyway, I'm going to put on my podcast, and let's all get to work. Do, do, do. Oh, I forgot that thing I was going to say. Welcome to Studio Mate in another state, or may I help you, which I find myself saying 8,000 times a day at my new job. Hi, welcome to our store. Have you shopped with us before? You haven't? You're my guest. Which I love, actually. I really enjoy it. Anyway, let's get to work. Let's put the show on the road. It's been so long, my mineral spirits have dried out. Paint's dry, the mineral spirits are cloudy. Too long. It's a mess. Everything's a mess. It's my housemate. I'm going to use the front door. Come through here.
just after the town set free, just after the end of the Gilded Age, Twin City was rapidly expanding, bursting with new arrivals, yet the city was fixing and captivating on something seemingly criminally afoot in high society.
But they weren't just captivated for a few months. This story was kept in the news for decades, and was not just of interest to New Yorkers,
strange that today so little is known or remembered about this case.
And it's interesting to me too that the world of high surveillance today is always being watched.
Okay, is it bad? We're still there. Rutenberg, Brian Rutenberg. That's who I was, not Ratzenberg, Rutenberg. I watch his videos. Brian Rutenberg out of New York. Awesome artist, really funny YouTuber. Yeah, he's the one who has tubes of this particular product featured in his the opening on his videos. God, he's awesome.
Says Arnold's vegetable hair balls.
Oh, my hair balls?
Knows what kind of
colors.
Right.
this time than any of these reporters, but quite a number of illustrations of even a few photographs of people knew who she was, as though she was a significant kind of celebrity herself. So this poor woman happened to strongly resemble by several people that claimed that she was Dorothy Arnold but was pretending not to be.
As if she had headed out to LA to start fresh and have her own career.
As many people have done before, I mean, but it wasn't her, and quote, owing to stringent circumstances, she was verging on a nervous breakdown. Now, the following year, April 1960, so we're over 5 years.
It's hot out here again.
North of the city. Now, this story, of course, was also relating to a back alley.
I'm going to try raising the garage door just a little bit more. Very little light in here. It's extremely hot. So friggin' hot in here. I can barely breathe. It's affecting me and how I paint, so I think. It's like, next killing me.
You know, and then I start thinking about that, and you know, there are many writers novelists who I deeply admire, like Ross McDonald.
Was the story
have a smash where you created Ed's hand and Ted's rope for one season. Great idea for a show. Beautifully executed. Got good rating. A kind of Golden Globe nomination. People liked it. And but then this, ironically, this show about backstage drama became a big backstage drama. And yes, you were then one of the stars. So what happened?
This has probably been about an hour that we've been together. I have done some work, as you can probably see. I'm not sure. You know, once again, I got caught up in the background, but I decided to move down to her dress, to this young lady's dress. However, I really am very, very, very tired, and I'm starting to have little RSD seizures. So I'm going to take a break. Maybe tonight I'll be back online, painting live. But as I said earlier, I've been working a new 9-to-5 job. It's been 6 days a week. up to 11, 12 hours a day. So I am beyond wiped. Today, from now on, I will have 2 days off a week. Part of my day will be my own. Nighttime, we have a storm coming, so it's killing me. Anyway, it should be back to regular. Regular me making videos more regularly. Now, do not forget, please do not forget, next Saturday, October 20th, I will be at Chasing Galleries in downtown Sarasota, or on South Osprey, rather. I will be at Chasing Galleries in Sarasota on South Osprey. I don't know the time yet. As soon as I know, you'll know. It's really been a very busy couple of months, and so we haven't really get to that part. But we will, and I will let you know. It'll be up on my Facebook page. Hopefully, it'll be up on Instagram. As I said, I made some progress in this, but it really is time to take a break. And part of being a professional is to know when you really have to take a break. And right now, every nerve in my body is on fire and screaming at me. So time to take a break. All right, I'll see you later. And thank you for your patience over the last few months. But we'll get back to it now, okay? Well, not now, but in a little while. Anyway, ciao.